Good evening, Arete families. I am very excited to welcome you here in person to congratulate our ninth graders. Tonight, we celebrate our rising ninth graders. Joining me here are our eighth grade teachers who have worked hand in hand with our students throughout their journey in eighth grade, as well as two high school students, which we will hear speak about their transition into high school. Eighth graders, please stand. This evening, Jesse.
Up to Now, being a freshman, you're officially going to be recognized as a high schooler, which is so super cool. Plus, in a regular school year, you automatically get top blockers. However, you will be told you're considered at the bottom of the food chain. But in spite of that, Mrs. Gillingham is asking to reflect on what high school has been like for me at Arete, and share with you the experience as a whole so that you can gain perspective on what it's like moving up in the ranks. Before I get into it, here's some basic details about me. I play volleyball, basketball, and run track and field. I'm a mentor, did guitar club for a couple of years, and I'm involved in Cannibal Choir as well as student life. I am beyond thankful for the opportunities I had in these communities, because if it wasn't for sports and clubs, I would have had a very different experience. It's a mixture of all the high school grades, and you learn, grow, and develop new friendships continuing outside of the classroom. I can't stress enough how much getting involved has been my favorite part of Arete, especially since it is a smaller school. The people here care and are interested in the culture, as well as you all understand what kind of work is being asked of you here. Plenty of the faculty leading these and the upperclassmen are equipped to pour into you their wisdom as you engage in activities of similar interests. I didn't even grow up with sports, and I don't have any regrets since I picked them up. So, I deeply encourage you all to get involved and seize the opportunities, utilizing them and reaping all the benefits they have to offer. Academically speaking, the first thing I have to say is good grades are cool. I'll keep this part short, but in general, take this as an incentive to do well rather than a pressure if you don't. It takes off unnecessary extra stress. It demonstrates that you've cultivated healthy academic habits. And in the longer run, it looks good when you're seeking potential colleges and jobs. A present benefit that staying on top of your grades also has is that when everything's completed, you then have your own free time without worries. My advice on how to achieve this is simply to try your best. It sounds cliche, but try harding has great results. Being willing to put forth effort is already half the battle, and teachers at the school give credit when you demonstrate the work you're putting in. I know that probably everyone in this room will end up procrastinating during each year of high school, but be aware of what works best for you considering your weaknesses and strengths. I personally know that I'm blessed and cursed with the ability to hyper-focus on a task, but also be distracted very easily, which ends up in disregarding my work. So, when it comes time to do my homework, I make sure to be intentional about removing my primary distractions, such as my phone, my computer, and just staying away from my family because they're kind of loud, and set aside some time dedicated to what needs to get done. Speaking of time, be sure to manage your time. The school provides a planner for you every year, and I didn't start taking advantage of that until I started filling out my schedule. Being organized and getting healthy sleep is very respectful, because sleep is the first thing I plan, because how am I expected to operate and fully function physically and mentally when both my body and brain aren't recharged properly? I would describe high school at Arete as an environment where seeds can blossom, but it's up to the student to invest in preparing and tilling the soil. As corny as this metaphor is, I will continue on to say that your teachers will water you. An extension of what I said earlier about getting involved at Arete is get to know your teachers. Especially at this school, they literally have signed up to be more than an information provider. You can ask Mr. Vaughn and Mrs. Atkins specifically. They are both my teachers at some point, and I would go talk with them before they were both deans. The faculty is passionate about being here and are eager to assist you all. That's why they always ask, what can I do to help? Overall, high school will be what you make of it. Some of you have parents who chose you to come here, and it feels like you had no say. I know I did. But while you're here, there is so much room for growth and to be your own person. Reflecting back, I am glad I got to stay. I'm thrilled to see what adventure senior year has for me, and I hope to see all your faces next year, as well as your blog friends. Thank you.
I've been a middle school lab teacher watching all these students grow and mature for the past
It has truly been an honor to teach these students for as brief or as long as I have, and I wanted one last opportunity to speak to all of them before they move on to high school and most of them forget all the Latin they've ever learned, or so I've been told. First, I would like to congratulate you on making it this far in your educational career. You might not realize how much you've accomplished in the past 3 years, so let me give you a snapshot of your achievements. If you have been at Arete since sixth grade, you have read a total of 15 books, two of which were Shakespeare, and you have written at least that many essays. You have also used those books to discuss important and challenging topics in seminars. You have studied over 6,000 years of human history from ancient Mesopotamia through the Hundred Years' War and much of American history. You have dissected 5 organisms, become a biological expert on different biospheres, learned and applied Newton's laws, built a Rube Goldberg machine, filtered water, and even directed a mission to Mars. You have learned how to think and solve problems algebraically, performed a Shakespeare play with what I consider perfect comedic timing, written and performed your own plays in Latin, and of course translated 54 chapters of Latin stories while encountering increasingly complex and nuanced grammar. I can go on with what you have learned, but I think you can get the picture. Not only that, though, you accomplished all of this while also managing to learn 2 different online learning systems with their own uploading, downloading, and whatever else kind of loading might have happened, made it to 6 Zoom classes a day, and watched a lot of goofy videos to help you understand the information. I'm talking Hypaws and Mickey's Staircraft. You and your families have navigated online school, in-person school, masks, block classes, and social distancing, all while keeping positive attitudes and giving your teachers more patience than I thought was possible. For overcoming these hurdles and learning something, despite all the distractions, you are to be commended. So far, I have emphasized your past. It is easier to think about that because it is familiar and, in that way, comfortable. But I would be remiss if I did not look at your future for a moment. High school will come with many challenges. You will be challenged mentally, physically, if you join any sports, and perhaps even emotionally as you navigate school and life. You will be asked to read a wide variety of literature and discuss the true, good, and beauty within them. You will be introduced to the basic forces and laws that govern our world and will be asked to explain how those laws affect specific situations. You will be asked to balance equations in math and chemistry. You will be asked to have conversations in new and foreign languages or translate the authors who influenced many modern authors and the founding fathers. You will be taught the social and political atmospheres that affected wars and moments throughout history. You will be asked to analyze poetry and plays alike. And at the end of it all, you will be asked to write a thesis paper summarizing some of the themes you have noticed throughout your literature and seminars. But with all these things that will happen to you, I would encourage you to not take a backseat in this journey. Engage in conversations, even difficult ones, to learn for yourself the truths your teachers are sharing. Find those topics that you are passionate about and pursue them. Figure out how to find joy in the classes or topics that you are not as interested in. Use the patience you have learned this year on yourself, your family, and your classmates. Become masters of your own education. If I taught you in 6th or 7th grade, you got used to me asking every Monday, quid ficisti feridis, which is to say, what'd you do over the weekend? But today, as I look to your future, I ask a different question. Quid facitis, or what will you do? I look forward to seeing and hearing what you accomplish in high school and beyond. Good luck.
Section 8B to the stage, and Ms. Krentenberger will be calling Section 8A. Those those in attendance, please honor each student with a super clap, and we will have a raucous round of applause after each section has been completed. Now, do we all know how to super clap?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, let's do a practice run very quickly, because our orientation is a little awkward right now, with journals down here, and I have certificates up at the stage. So let's see, Mr. Patty, would you be willing to assist me? Thank you so much. Mr. Patty, could you please stand over by the journals? All right. And Mr. Lerner, you've been teaching eighth grade for quite a while, but you very recently took over one of the sections Latin classes. Can you be our sample student? All right, great, thank you. Joseph Lerner. So then you head up to this, yep. Get your journal from Mr. Patty. Oh, okay. It's a good thing we're having Mr. Lerner practice it, right? And then come on up. All right. And then we'll make a little change because I see we have an issue. Mr. Lerner, would you be willing to stand up here and help hand out the certificates? Thank you so much. Perfect. All right, what would we prefer? Full claps for everyone or super claps?
Super claps. Guys, it's not the Arete way for doing full claps.
Full claps, and I suppose we can do that. All right, so we'll start with AB. Grant Baxla.
Thank you.
Let's hear a round of applause for 8B. Please welcome Ms. Kennenberger to the podium.
Decisions were family decisions made to support health well-being of family members. This year was full of agonizing choices and uncertainty. I am grateful to see you all finish this year. I have nothing similar to pull on from my past. No story with which to exhort you. You are in historic times. Trailblazing, what it means to be excellent while surrounded with turmoil. The questions you have faced this year, you will continue to face. What does it mean to have true discourse during discord? What does it mean to stand up and do what is right while people suffer around you? You have faced these questions, and you will again. I'd like to share a quote from the book you just finished, To Kill a Mockingbird, by Judge Taylor. He says, people generally see what they look for and hear what they listen for. This quote points to the truest thing in our natures, the reason that it is critical for us to examine ourselves and those around us. Critical that we read and discuss great works and challenge us to see beyond ourselves. In answering these questions of discourse and suffering here at Arete Prep, you will be faced with conflicting opinions and circumstances. You will have the opportunity to immerse yourselves in the text, all while being surrounded and supported by your community, family, friends, and teachers. Eighth grade, thank you for your hard work and perseverance this year. I look forward to standing in front of you in 2025 and reflecting on all of your accomplishments. Cheers to the class of 2025.
Cookies are actually in the back, and there's gluten-free cookies as well.
Thank you.
Yeah,
I want to
shake her hand.
Yeah, I got it.
Okay. You need to go shake her hand.
Yeah, I know. This is so